many values to unpack. You just used Stack Overflow to make things work somehow. Now you are thinking you are the smartest programmer on the earth. That's the number one mistake that most of the junior programmers make, which is the moment they are given a task, a Jira story in their software development project, they immediately start writing the code. So they don't do enough thinking before they write first line of code. And while they're writing the code also, they just go to Stack Overflow, copy paste the code, and make things work somehow. There are four dimensions of this thinking process that I want to talk about. The very first dimension of that thinking process is think like an end user. Let's say this little panda is the end user of your website. Then ask, why does this panda need to add that new button on my website? People argue that my business manager has done enough thinking and given me this beautiful requirement document, and my job is to translate that requirement document into a working code. Well, again, wrong. You're not a stupid code monkey whose job is to translate some requirement document into a working code. You are a problem solver. As a full stack engineer, you need to be understanding your business problems and writing good code that can actually solve those problems. And sometimes not writing a lot of code can help the end user better. He's your end user. You see his face. I have a friend who was given a project to work on, and he thought, we should not be working on this project because there is this existing solution which we can just customize it and use it. And he spent a lot of time in thinking before writing the first line of code, and the project got cancelled. He saved a couple of million dollars for the company. See, as a programmer, it's not like you have to write code. Sometimes by not writing code, you can be helping your company. And that thing comes if you have a good business understanding, which requires that you have a lot of discussions and meeting with your business manager. If it is possible, try to do shadowing sessions with your end user, so that end user is using your software, you're sitting and you're asking questions, you see them using your software, so you understand their habit patterns better and things like that. And you don't have to think that, will I look stupid if I ask this question? No question is a stupid question. That's how you build domain understanding. That's how you become a better software engineer. The second dimension of that thinking process is data structures and algorithms. Without data structures and algorithms, you cannot be a good programmer, period. If you want to improve your data structure fundamentals, watch my tutorials on YouTube where I have given tutorials on both data structures and algos along with the exercises. And there are few other resources that you can follow, such as an awesome website called Gigs for Gigs. Gigs for Gigs website has a lot of good resources, free articles on data structures and algorithms, and you can practice different type of DSA problems on this website. Other than data structures and algorithm, they have a lot of material on interview preparation. I myself have referred to this website whenever I have appeared in any job interviews. These questions are excellent, and if you solve it, your chances of getting selected in any company will increase. And they have a lot of courses as well that you can explore, live courses, online courses, both. And just take those courses, learn those things, and make your programming skills better. They cover a wide range of topics from C++, Java, Python, competitive programming. Recently, they added machine learning as well. Check it out. Majority of the content on this website is free. So you have a bunch of customer records, and these records have the country that the customer belongs to, and you want to retrieve unique list of countries for all your records. Now you can use list as a data structure and then remove duplicates later on. But if you have a knowledge of set data structure, then you can use that in first go, and it will not only make your code compact, but it will reduce bugs too. Now you see how data structure knowledge can help you write better code. Third dimension of this thinking process is design principles and scalability and performance considerations. Even as a junior programmer, you need to be thinking about how better you can make the system design. And there are many resources that you can refer to. For example, my friend Gauro Sen has this amazing YouTube channel where he talks about system design and general, you know, principles behind scalability and performance. The other good resource is Designing Data Intensive Application. That book is like a must. Once you read that book, you get a lot of knowledge on designing better system overall, and that can make you a good programmer overall. Martin Fowler's blog is another great resource. Nowadays, if you appear for an interview in any of these FANG companies or any MANG companies, they will ask you system design questions. Fourth dimension is you should not be afraid of refactoring the code. You're working on this code base which is designed by some expert programmers in your company who are your seniors, but doesn't mean that they are right all the time. They can be writing a creepy, crappy, messy code, whatever. As a junior programmer, you need to be thinking that, okay, I'm all powerful, I can write better code, I can refactor things. So don't be afraid of refactoring. This is one common mistake that I have seen people make, especially junior programmers. Hey, can you tell me something about yourself? I'm Dhaval Patel. I'm a React Native developer. You're what? I'm a React Native developer. I like to build application in React Native. It is so cool. And that's the second biggest mistake that most of the junior programmers make. Instead of saying, I want to build world-class, scalable, responsive mobile applications, they say, I am a React Native developer. They get too much attached to a specific framework or a programming language. We all know these frameworks and programming languages, they evolve, they come and go. And if you have too much unnecessary emotional attachment, you're putting your career in danger. You need to have this attitude of a problem solver. I'm a problem solver. I can take a business problem, use technology to solve this problem. And this theme is very much conveyed in this famous clip of the movie 300.
You there, what is your profession? I'm a potter. And you, Arcadian, what is your profession?
Sculptor, sir.
You?
Blacksmith.
Spartans! What is your profession?
If you don't have this flexible attitude of a problem solver, what will happen is, let's say you are a Java programmer, you are given a task of machine learning. Now you'll try to do machine learning in Java, which is not a good idea. You know, Python or R are probably the languages you should be using for machine learning. So you have heard this quote before, correct? The third one is they get so much obsessed with tutorials and certifications that they get machine learning certificate, then DevOps certificate, and then some cloud certification. What the hell you're going to do with all these certificates? They're useless. Focus more on the implementation. Focus less on consuming the tutorials and consuming the information related to various programming concepts. Because the internet is full with so many courses, so many YouTube videos, and there is, you know, even let's say I want to learn Kubernetes, you will find hundreds of tutorials. And if you keep on watching one tutorial after other, you're not helping yourself. Just watch one tutorial and try to implement that freaking thing. You know, that's how you learn the things. You want to learn swimming? All right, do this. Watch 10 swimming videos. What's gonna happen? Nothing. You have to jump in the pool and try it out yourself. The fourth one is not giving enough importance to debugging skills and productivity tools. I know many junior programmers who don't know even what is conditional breakpoint. Do you know what is conditional breakpoint, by the way? Well, I have a nice video which you can watch. But the point I want to make here is, as a programmer, you're stuck in this repetitive iterations, you know, where you write some code, you get some error, you debug it, you fix it, write some other code. So if you want to improve the efficiency of these iterations, you need to have a very good debugging skills where you learn about things like conditional breakpoint, how to debug your code in IDE in general, the call stack, the watch variables, you know, stepping into the code, stepping out of the code, things like that. You need to have a good understanding of all those amazing concepts. Productivity tool is another thing. I have seen programmers who just try to do things with the mouse. You know, you need to get yourself familiar with the shortcuts, the keyboard shortcuts of IDE, and you can work really fast. Let's say there is a menu you want to open in IDE, and now every time you're going and clicking the button, instead of that, if you know the shortcut, let's say Control J, you're saving 2 seconds on each iterations, and this way you can improve your efficiency a whole lot. And that's a common mistake I have seen with the new programmers, that they don't spend enough time in learning productivity tools, in learning debugging tools. You know, many times you can install plugins. Let's say you are using Visual Studio Code. Well, install this plugin called GitHub Copilot, which can just auto suggest the code. You know, people don't spend too much time in the actual setup, and then they suffer eventually. And the last one is over engineering, overthinking, and, you know, just spending unnecessary extra time in coming up with the designs which might not be needed. You know, don't build for the future. Just be very reasonable in your approach. Do enough design thinking, but don't over engineer things. There are, for example, if you're using Python, there are so many ready-made modules out there, so just use them. You know, don't try to reinvent the wheel. And that's again one of the common mistakes I've seen. Programmers, they tend to over engineer things and tend to make things unnecessarily complex. You know, you are in your sprint cycle, you want to get this feature out, and you need to have a reasonable approach. Of course, think about system design, think about code quality, but don't go extreme. You know, the first point we discussed was not doing enough thinking, but this is another extreme where some junior programmers do too much overthinking. Right, so those are the common mistakes that I have come across in my professional career of 17 years of programming, mentoring so many junior programmers, interacting with people through my YouTube channel, and that's a pattern I have seen. If you know about any other common mistakes that the new programmers make, please post in a video comment below and I will try to respond and we can have a discussion. Thank you very much for watching, and I wish you all the best.